to get to these states, you cannot have a discriminative mind. So you cannot hold a view of being human, being an animal, being a god, being a dragon, being a flower, anything. The only way the flow would actually come through, or this state would arise for healing to take place, is if you don't put an obstruction in your way of your mind. So there is no self. There is no body. There's no views of an ego, a self, personality, a lifespan, other people. There's no views. It's just what's going on. And there is no now in general, because that's still an obstacle. So you got to let go of these views. And you'll find that a lot of things start to happen.
So you basically live your life how? Like, what's a typical Lynn day?
Oh, man. wake up.
Typical Lynn day.
Maybe about 5 o'clock in the morning. Get up.
Oh, just, I get up at 5 o'clock in the morning. I have no idea what.
Wash the face, warm water.
Right.
Go out to the school, because I stay in my school. I have a school in Brooklyn. And just practice for some
now
time.
Now, that's your school?
Yes, yes.
Maybe you can give the address so that people can contact you.
It's 6627 Bay Parkway, third floor.
And what is it called?
Jing Xin Yuan, which means Garden of Pure Heart. So it's spelled in Chinese pinyin, J-I-N-G, J-I-N-G, X-I-N, Y-U-A-N, and then you have the English Garden of Pure Heart.
Wonderful. Now, we're also going to have it on the credits. Mm. Rudy, and you, how do people contact you and where? And
They can contact me at my cell phone number as 347-605-9605 or rudy9086@gmail.com. And the other website is brothersofkuan.org. That's brothersofkuan.org.
Wonderful. Now, what would you recommend if someone wanted to get into martial arts, spirituality, you know, and martial arts, and they didn't want to go to a teacher, but they want to sort of, you know, get a jump start?
They can only go so far without a teacher. I would say stick to something less dramatic and less complicated and just do sitting meditation or just basic standing. What do you think, Sifu?
Well, they need to search for one thing. When I started studying, I had some neighbors that knew karate, and, you know, karate was the basic thing going around, but very few esoteric people that took it to the next level were around. So I sought. I went around to schools and watched for almost a year before I finally settled down into a school that I decided to study with. And they did meditation. It was a holistic program. And it wasn't just everybody in there punching and kicking each other, wearing protective gear. They were meditating. The teacher was
You walk in and there's blood all over the place.
Yeah.
You know, I wanted to go to a spiritual place. Instead, there's blood everywhere.
Well, the funny thing is, when I walked in there, everybody was fighting full throttle with no protective gear. That was what caught my eye.
Well, what kind of protective gear? I mean, you're talking about samurai?
No, the crap they wear today. The boxing gloves, the headgear, the shin pads.
Wait a minute. Let me put my samurai shield on.
No, because I took it martial arts.
Steven Spielberg movie, or is this a class?
Oh, yeah. No, what happens is nowadays people train is not realistic. I mean, they say they need to learn how to take punishment, but you're supposed to be learning how to not take punishment. So if you practice without the gear, you'll be a little bit more accurate with your techniques.
Yeah.
And years ago they used to put on all this armor?
Well, in the 70s they started wearing this stuff because the regulatory commissions and the government got involved in a few things because of a few accidents. Yeah. But in the old days we didn't train with that stuff.
And trained like you dressed.
You learned, well, no, we trained however
we
were dressed.
I don't know what trained
but
to do here.
What happened was, like we said, we developed the respect and the control to learn how to use your technique without killing your classmates.
Right. And well, that's always a plus.
That's a plus.
You know, there's a guideline in the Kung Fu, in our training. It's if you can kill, you maim. If you can maim, you control. If you can control, you can talk. And if you can talk, you obviously can walk away.
Yeah.
So, in other words, you really could, you look, honestly, you look like the sweetest guy, but I'll tell you, I would totally get in the dark alley with you.
You know, it's a complete martial artist knows how to fight and knows how to heal. It can destroy and create.
Yeah.
Well, I could see it in his eyes that, you know, one little
dude,
and you're dead.
Yeah, a lot of people, they mistake the smile sometimes for weakness. But what happened was this teacher that I met, here's how I actually really got into the martial arts. It was an old guy, and I watched this class I would watch every week because they did the forms, they did the meditation, they did the fighting, and it was just something there. All of the people were glowing, they were older, and one day he asked me, are you going to join or not? I said, yeah, but I thought I was good. I said, I think I could tangle with some of your students. And he says, well, come and try me out for size. And I went to the side with him, and I took a boxing shuffle and moved around, and he stood there with his hands at his sides. So I looked at him like, aren't you going to get ready? And I shuffled again, and he just laughed. So I swung the fastest punch I had at the time at him. And it was a meditative state. It was like time froze.
Wow.
The next thing I know, his hands were on my chest touching lightly. It felt like when a baby touches you. My feet were 3 feet off the ground, and I went flying across the room and slammed into the wall. He did that to me 3 times, almost like he was playing handball. And I literally felt a force of come out of his hand. And he said, are you ready to learn? I said, where do I sign up? Right. And from there was a journey.
I think I'm going to skip that class.
Yeah, this one. But he was deep into meditation. He said, yes. You need how to learn how to use your mind and learn how to see reality.
Well, you see, that's what I'm talking about constantly on my show.
Yes.
How powerful thoughts are. If somebody, we did a healing, my teacher and I once, on... And as everyone knows who watches the show, my teacher is a master healer. Mm. He healed me of multiple sclerosis many years ago. We had someone that willed herself to be paralyzed from the waist down. She kept seeing herself paralyzed. And so guess what?
That's what she was.
There you go. Well,
but he turned it around.
Well, here's an interesting story from Sufi Roosevelt.
We might get cut off because I think.
Okay. Well, there was a lady paralyzed, but she could still feel. He used to go in and squeeze her foot and make her jump. And the doctors kept telling her she's paralyzed for life. And he told her, if you could still feel, you're not paralyzed.
That's what Freud used to say. And it's all mental.
He squeezed her foot every day until she started shaking, and then she forced him to stop giving her the medication.
Thank you, guys, because you guys are so fascinating. We want to have you back again. Thank you.
Okay.
Alexandra's Psychic Eye is the foremost talk show on the paranormal on Community Access. We're here every Friday night in Staten Island and Brooklyn and Thursday afternoons in Manhattan on your local Community Access cable station. Visit PsychicEye.tv or call me, Alexandra, at 718-983-8443. Again, that number is 718-983-8443 to receive information on our psychic healing seminars, readings, past life regressions, and healings. In the meantime, remember, you're all in a state of grace, so continue to work on you. This is Alexandra for Alexandra's Psychic Eye. See you next time. Yep. That was a great show. Thank you.